Welcome to Red Eye. I'm Greg Gutfeld. We're here with Rachel Marsden, Bill Schultz, Fox Business correspondent Rebecca Gomez. How are you, Rebecca?
Good.
And out in Boston, we have former assistant director in charge of the FBI for New York, Bill Gavin, who is now president of the Gavin Group of Boston. Hello.
Hey, Greg.
How you doing?
I'm doing well. And yourself?
I'm awake, which is good for 2 a.m. Let's think about what's going on in Japan. Right now it is illegal for humans to go out and try to entice people into sex clubs. So now what they have done is they've built robots to be out on the street to call out to people to come into their sex club. I think we have a picture. There's one of them. It looks kind of frightening. I don't know if it's frightening or if it's sexy. Trekkie Monster, how do you feel about robots in general? Do they scare you?
But no, and you all may have to say is domo arigato, Mr. Roboto. Now me never be lost in Osaka. Yeah. Never.
Rebecca, are we seeing just another example of robots stealing humans' jobs?
Yeah, pretty soon the robots are going to be there in the sex club, too. So they'll take away those girls' jobs.
Trademark that.
Oh, am I on to something here?
And they're more flexible, too, I heard, robots.
Well,
so they might
really,
be better performers.
I thought they were the opposite. They're really stiff.
I don't know. Ball and socket joints, I think.
Trekkie, I think, wouldn't it be great if you had a robot puppet hybrid?
Oh, yeah, me like that so much, you know, but you have to lubricate every so often.
That is true. Bill, you've had a lot of experience with puppets, haven't you?
I do love puppets.
31-year relationship with this thing, right?
And yes. He wears it mostly on his face.
All right.
This is a very clever way to get around a stupid law, and I say kudos to those crazy Asians.
Yeah,
they did a good job.
I want to talk about this new study that came out that found that the active compound in marijuana, known as THC, might help prevent or reduce the incidence of lung tumors. Of course, the study was done in mice, incredibly stoned mice, I might add. And the doctors, the researchers, said you should not take this study as a means to self-medicate.
Hey, my feeling on this is, my lungs are feeling better already.
You look great.
Oh, thank you.
Are you hungry at all?
As a matter of fact.
What do puppets eat? Do they have, like, puppet nachos or puppet Doritos?
Foam cookies.
Foam cookies. Yeah. Fantastic.
Otherwise known as Cheetos, right?
Cheetos, yes. Exactly. Or Funyuns. Funyuns are kind of foamy. Rebecca, isn't it time that we start looking at illicit drugs, not as illicit drugs, but as active medical compounds? Because I feel like we're closing the door on so many potential therapies.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm from California. Of course, when you said the study was done in, I was waiting for you to say San Francisco or something, but it was in mice. I mean, if this is naturally in our bodies anyway, according to this study, what is it? What do they call them? Cannabinoid system?
Mm.
You have a cannabinoid system, so memory failure and kind of like dizziness and my losing my train of where I'm going. THC in my system.
Mm-hmm.
And you can pass drug tests then.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank Bill? God Fox News doesn't test, Greg.
Yes.
Speaking for Go-Go on this one.
Yeah.
But I think that's great, but I can't get over the fact that we have a stone puppet on air tonight. You're not going to find that on O'Reilly.
A stuppet.
Thank you.
There he is. Yeah, he doesn't know where he is. Rachel, knowing the therapeutic effects of THC, would you start smoking marijuana?
Like she doesn't already?
like, that's a bit of a loaded question. Are you insinuating that I'm from Vancouver, or it's just like the capital
there was
of pot
no,
smoking
there was
after
no
Amsterdam?
Canadian illusion there, was there?
No, well then what kind of illusion was that?
Calm down. Take a chill pill.
What were you getting at then?
I was just saying, would you take it? I want to move on, though, because this is beginning to scare me. I want to talk about these potheads that accidentally called 911. They were planning to call their dealer because they so badly needed marijuana that they actually called 911 and were arrested by the cops, which also found burglary tools with them. I think they were just signed in and released. Nikki, have you ever accidentally called somebody you didn't mean to call?
What was the question?
I don't even remember the question either. That was good, Nikki. That was good stuff, by the way.
Oh.
I need to get your guy's number.
Hey, it's not 911.
This whole thing is very clearly a setup by the man, and that's capital T, capital M, trying to stifle entrepreneurial spirit. It's a big, big setup.
You can't
Did I hear the puppet whisper?
You can use big words like that when we're all hired.
What, the man?
I thought I was the only one who didn't get it.
Rebecca, but doesn't this point out how kind of like wonderfully harmless potheads are, and that they shouldn't be thrown in jail because clearly these guys had burglary tools and they couldn't even rob because they were too high.
Well, they did have a stolen car, but, you know, let's not let the facts get in the way of a good story now, right?
Yes, I never let that be a problem.
But, you know, as far as, like, getting things mixed up, that's totally understandable because have you ever sent the text message to the wrong person?
Yes.
In fact, that happened to a girlfriend of mine. She got a text message from a guy saying, oh, wear that beautiful, lovely red dress tonight, honey. Wait a minute, I thought you were out of town. So
I sent the same thing to President Bush. I'm still being followed.